Another way to bring PEX out of the wall is to use one of these. Now this is a PEX support bracket, or a PEX support wall bracket. And what it has on here are several holes. These holes here, I can feed a 3/4 inch pipe through. Just bring that right out of the wall. These holes here, I can take and bring a 1/2 inch pipe to and bring it out of the wall this way. Or one of the other nice features of these bend supports is they're large enough on these 3/4 inch outlets to house a bend support. So I can take and I can snap a bend support in place and then bring 1/2 inch pipe through the bend support and out of the wall. And then I'm ready to make my final connections to the fixture. What I like about bend supports and wall brackets is that they add rigidity to a PEX piping system where you wouldn't normally have it if you were just bringing straight PEX out of the wall. So it's a very inexpensive way to add rigidity, and it makes your system last longer because you're not transitioning to a piece of copper that that will eventually wear out faster than the PEX in the system. So with that, let's kind of walk over here and demonstrate how that might work. So I've got a wall support bracket already in place. I'm going to pick my spots, I'll go one hole away from the edge. That just snaps in there. This one snaps in here. And then we've got to get somehow from here back to the multi-port T. And I say it that way because the best way to pipe these is to go from the wall bracket back to the multi-port T so you don't waste pipe. So I've got a coil of pipe over here I'm going to grab. And I want to get this coil of pipe from this connection back to the multi-port T and not waste a lot of material. So to do that, simply stated, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to quickly remove this bracket to make my job easier. And then from this point, I'm going to go through. I drilled some holes up here to demonstrate a couple of things. I didn't plan ahead, and so my holes are nowhere near where I want to run this pipe. And that makes installation a lot more difficult. So as I'm running this through, I got a lot of bends that I got to take care of to get this pipe back there. So I'm my own worst enemy here because I drilled my holes so stupidly. Actually, I did it to prove a point. Yeah, that works. I did it to prove a point. So once I have enough pipe to get to my connection, give myself a little bit more so I've got some slack. Now, because I didn't drill my holes out, I can't make the sweeps that I would normally make. So what I'm going to do is give myself a little bit of mechanical help by using these bend supports. So with this 1/2 inch pipe, I'll put a bend support in place here. That's real nice. I'm going to go off this top outlet here. So I should really use another bend support here, just to give myself a little bit more rigidity. So right up here, I'm going to use another bend support so that I'm not risking a kink when I make these connections. And then now when I get over here, this is a pretty tight bend too. So I'm going to use another bend support right there. Let's see, I got at least one more here. So one last bend support, oops, will get me where I need to go. Bear with me 1 second, viewers. Need some 1/2 inch rings to make this possible. So to make these connections, what I'm going to do is take this expansion head that I was using for 3/4 inch off and put a 1/2 inch expansion head onto the tool. Then I'll take a 1/2 inch ring, throw it onto the pipe here. And just simply connect it to my 4/4 multi-port T. Like so. Okay, so this is all supported. Now I'm at this part where I can come out of the wall. And what I'll do is I'll cut this pipe just a little bit long so that I can get it into the bend support. After I'm done making these connections, oh, thanks, Stephen. After I'm done making these connections, I'll put a cap on and then pressure test the system.